Welcome. This is the schematic representation of a functioning petroleum system. In this and the coming clips, we will go through it. At the end, you will have a good idea of how to predict the occurrence of hydrocarbons in the subsurface. Everything starts with a source rock. A good source rock has a high total organic content, usually more than 1%, and has been heated enough to generate petroleum. Three stages are then needed to obtain a high-quality source rock. Sediments rich in organic matter must be deposited. The organic matter must be preserved during subsidence, and the rock must be heated at high enough temperatures. This is more complicated than what it looks like. Abundant organic matter is generally produced in swamps as well as in marine environments. In these places, oxygen, light, and nutrients are abundant, making it possible for flora and fauna to thrive. These living organisms, plants or animals, form the organic matter you will find in the source rock. The next and possibly more difficult challenge for nature is to preserve the organic matter that has been deposited. The big enemy of organic matter is oxygen, which oxidizes and destroys the organic matter. The process is called oxidation and implies that oxygen is consumed to oxidize the organic matter. The system works like a candle. As long as oxygen is available, the flame will burn and oxidation will continue. For our purposes, this means that the organic matter will be oxidized and will disappear. This is what happens to more than 95% of the organic matter deposited in sediments. If, however, no new oxygen can be added to the system, the flame will consume all the available oxygen and will then die out. Oxidation has stopped. In our analogy, organic matter will escape oxidation and will be preserved. Zones with no oxygen are called anoxic. Where do these anoxic zones form? We can then predict the occurrence of organic matter depth if we are able to identify the environments with anoxic conditions. In swamps, most of the organic matter is created by plants and organisms living at the surface. When these die, they fall to the floor of the water column and get oxidized, creating anoxic conditions. With persisting subsidence, the sediment rich in organic matter will be buried and will not experience oxidation as the entire environment is anoxic. If these conditions persist, thick succession of potentially good source rock are created. Anoxic conditions are also present, though not common, in the marine environment. An important example is that of isolated marine basins. The most famous example is the Black Sea. The Black Sea is a deep basin surrounded from nearly all sides by continental masses and with only a narrow and shallow connection with the Mediterranean Sea along the Bosphorus. Two types of waters enter the Black Sea. Large rivers bring huge amounts of fresh water and a limited amount of very saline water coming from the Mediterranean. In a vertical section across the basin, you can see that the saline, heavy water entering from the left will immediately descend to deeper levels because of its high density. The fresh water from the rivers, on the contrary, is lighter and will then remain at the top of the basin, forming a lid. The water column is thus stratified and lithical vertical movements will take place. This means that no oxygen will be delivered to the lower part of the water column, which will then become anoxic. Living organisms thriving in the upper part of the water column will, upon death, sink through the water column, experience oxidation, and will pile up on the basin floor. Similar situations, although at smaller scales, are common, for instance, in small basins developed during the early stages of rifting. In frankly marine regions, for instance, along passive continental margins like the one shown in the slide, an oxygen-poor zone is at depths of several hundreds of meters, caused by the decay of organic matter from the organisms thriving in the upper part of the water column. If the anoxic zone persists, organic matter sinking through the water column and reaching the seafloor in this depth interval will be preserved and form potentially interesting source rocks. In previous slides, we have seen that organic matter can only be preserved in basin floors with anoxic conditions and, that anoxic conditions are destroyed by strong currents. These conditions were particularly well developed in some periods during the history of the Earth. If we look at the Earth during the Cretaceous, that is around 80 million years ago, we see a large ocean elongated in east-west direction, bounded to the north and the south by continental masses. In a north-south transect from one pole to the other, you can see that temperatures in the ocean were higher than present. And even more importantly, temperature gradients in north-south direction were very low. All this resulted in weak currents and a stratification of the water column. The Cretaceous was also a time of very high sea level, which caused the inundation of large continental domains and the delivery of large amounts of nutrients to the marine domain. A lot of nutrients, poor vertical ocean circulation, ideal conditions to form high organic content rocks. No surprise that a very large portion of world petroleum has been generated in Middle Cretaceous rocks.